climate change is proceeding. We haven't seen any positive indications in the atmosphere. And when it comes to oceans, the sea level rise has been seeing a boost in during the recent years. We have also seen the ocean warming to continue. We have stored more than 90% of the extra heat to oceans, and oceans are also serving as a sink of carbon, and the acidification of the seawater has continued. Oceans are part of the Earth system, and we have seen changes in temperatures. We have seen changes in the precipitation patterns. We have been breaking records in main greenhouse gases, especially carbon dioxide, that has also been leading to this further acidification of the ocean water. And these warmed oceans, they are also giving more energy for the tropical storms. We have seen devastating tropical storms, typhoons in Asia, and cyclones hitting the Pacific Islands and also southern part of Africa, like Mozambique. And we have broken the record in the amount of hurricanes in the Caribbean last year. We also have more humidity in the atmosphere, which is causing more severe flooding related to these storms. And actually, at the moment, Australia is suffering because of record-breaking flooding. During last century, we used to have 1 to 2 millimeters per year sea level rise, but during the recent years, we have seen 3 to 5 millimeters sea level rise. That's because of this warming of the oceans. It's expanding. We have also seen a boost in the glacier melting worldwide, especially in Greenland, and also the Antarctic glacier has started melting. And we have heard good news from many countries that they aim at becoming carbon neutral by 2050 or 2060. The key issue is that we have to start acting now.